much excited. But listen, Alexis is more than anything else to me.
You don't need to say it, because this whole thing is written all over you.
I think we also should start planning to get married. What do you think?
That's right, man. We should be fast about it, lest we end up becoming chronic bachelors.
Now listen, guys. Let's keep running, because I have to get fit for that day. You know it's a special day for me. Ah! Come on, let's go.
This kind of fit, I bet it looks like one.
No problem. Let's keep running, man.
I think I should do the business.
I like that one.
Thank you. Oh, sweetheart, you like this, but I don't like it. I think it doesn't suit me well.
Okay. Come on, girlfriend. You are so...
Okay. Accepted. It is nice.
Okay, go ahead.
That's what you said.
Okay.
But I have to try
another one. Then go ahead.
I love this. No, let's have to try another one. Let me just try it, please.
It's okay. I'm waiting.
Please don't be long.
Be careful. What? Oh my gosh! Just look at what you've done to my beads. You're sorry for deliberately destroying my favorite bead? Just get the hell out of the chamber now. Get out! Come back here, you wretch! Pick my beads off the floor and get your sorry self out of my chamber! God, she's so stupid. You, continue. Are you done? What? Shut up. Shut my door. Come here. Flowers. Now, what flower is going to be thrown at my royal feet today? What? Who processed the flowers? I guess the both of you did. I thought I told you goblins that I wanted red roses. And of all the flowers in the world, you had the guts to bring me this? Oh, you better be. Look, I am sick and tired of all this balderdash. The other day, I requested for water lilies. What did you bring? You brought yellow bells. Today, I asked for red roses. And you have the guts to bring me daffodils? I'm so pissed right now. I'm going to make sure you get severely punished for this. You get just a quarter of your money. Take me out of this place. idiots. Idiots.
I love
you. I spent all my last years no air to succeed. That's true. Fate has played a twisted joke on my life by taking away my only son, your husband, away from me. Now, he is the only man to succeed my royal lineage.
How?
Oh yes. Yet, all hopes can never be lost. As we have Princess Janice as a last resort. I hope she will one day marry to a man who will inherit.
That was the wish of my late husband.
I'm old now and I'm getting weaker day by day. I think I must fulfill the wish of my son.
Your Highness, so soon?
Ah, yes. Why do you think I call her from the United States? If not for her to get married as soon as possible. I don't want her to marry to any riffraff. I've selected a perfect gentleman for her.
Your Highness, if I may ask, who is that man?
Oh, it's Alan. He's the managing director of one of my companies.
Your Highness, why Alan?
It's so simple. I trusted him with my business. And he will make a good husband. Yes.
I think he's a good boy. And the position is right. But Your Highness.
Yes.
Will Princess Janice agree to short arrangement? I mean, considering Western ways of thinking?
Yes. She will just have to. Because I could not risk the storm and allow her to bring in any riffraff as an husband. In fact, I beg the news for right now. Who is there? Who is there?
Yes.
Yes. Go and call my daughter at a later presence. Now.
Yes.
21 years ago, your father was supposed to ascend the throne just after our death, as tradition demands. but hoping for the day to come that snatched him from us.
Grandfather, same old story, okay? I already know all this.
You have to exercise patience. Patience, which is also a mere part of royalty, is rarely what you lack.
I'm listening.
My dear, I am the only one left with this great empire, with no heir to succeed me when I've gone.
Oh, really? And you think that's a problem, grandfather? Oh my God! How wonderful! Amazing! Marvelous! Let's go. The Almighty Queen. Bonito Kingdom. Oh my God, I'm gonna be taught, admired, respected, and revered by my subjects. I'm gonna have so much to say. I'm gonna be a great queen during my reign. So grandfather, that's not a problem, okay? Because I can single-handedly rule this entire Bonito Kingdom. That is, if you want me to.
No. No. Again, it is forbidden for a woman to rule the little one. It has never, and it will never.
Say who?
Tradition.
Oh, well, I can be tradition
and
rule.
The only way you can get access to the throne, unless you get married.
What?
Yes. Married. Your husband shall rule as king and you will be the queen. And you know what? I've selected a perfect man for you. In fact, he is the managing director in one of my companies. His name is Alan Kekai.
You're not serious about this, grandfather, are you?
Oh yes. I'll arrange a meeting for you to commit so you start getting along.
Oh my God. Seriously, grandfather, I'm used to this. This is one of your daily jokes, right?
I've never been this serious in my entire life.
God, grandfather, you're so impossible. And seriously, I don't believe you, grandfather. Look at me. I'm not even ready for marriage yet, and you're here matchmaking me with some dumb stuff of yours. Mother, are you part of this? Princess, you have to understand. Did you just say understand, mother? Of course. I do understand. I understand you very well. How can I forget that it's always about you two? You and your father are so sane. Whenever it comes to making decisions about my own life, I think you're leaving it for me. Wait a minute. So this is what it's all about, huh? You called me from the States to come back home so that you can marry me after you told a stranger? Okay, it's all coming back to me,
your English. My dear, you have to understand that this is tradition. And I told you, we love tradition.
Oh well, not in this case.
Well, I'm sorry to disappoint you, but my decision is final.
Oh really? Well then, I'm also very sorry to disappoint you, my father. Because you see this chick standing here, read my lips. And be educated. I am never, ever
Janice!
One of you.
I am the king here.
Oh yes, you are the king. And I'm not disputing that part. But that is over your kingdom and your people. And not over my life.
Oh, shut up, Janice!
Don't dare me! Don't dare me, young lady. Because I won't take it.
Oh well, then you watch me.
Flowers! Take me out of here. I need some solitude. Janice, you can...
Come on. Janice, where do you think you're going?
To see my manicurist, no man else.
Sorry to disappoint you. You are grounded. Therefore, you will not leave this palace.
What?
Nor should anyone come and see you. Ah, yeah. Guards! Listen and listen carefully. Nobody should allow my daughter out of this palace. Do I make myself clear?
Yes, Your Highness.
But this is so not fair, Grandpa.
Life itself is unfair. You will remain grounded until you learn how to behave responsibly.
Why are you doing this to me? I don't even know this guy you keep talking about. This man you want me to marry. I don't know him.
But you said it's autograph. And I think he's quite a handsome guy, isn't he?
His photograph is not enough to make me love him, or is it?
You will learn to love him after your wedding.
What about true love, old man? What about true love?
My decision is final.
Love cannot be forced, okay?
What is happening here?
It's grandfather! Yeah. He's grounding me for getting married, for refusing to get married to a man I've never laid my eyes on. Why is he doing this to me?
Look, my princess. Grandpa and I want the best for you.
You want the best for me, mother? Mother, do you know what is best for me? You don't even know what is best for me, mother. Maybe what you think is best for me is seeing me cry every other day. If you think I'm gonna sit my butt down and watch you marry me after somebody I've never laid my eyes on, then think again, because you really need a rethink.
Now listen, young woman. If you think your grandfather will risk his throne for you, then you must be dreaming.
What is all this? I hate you. I just hate everybody in this palace.
What is all this, Janice?
That's...
What am I seeing? It seems like that Terrisi really wants your services today. That is why you guys are having fun.
Terrisi.
Indeed.
I'm fed up with her unbearable attitude in this palace.
Don't mind. Look at the way she was challenging the king. I pity the man that wants to marry her.
I guess she has been used to that American lifestyle. Wait a minute, are you trying to tell me that all the other girls that have been to America are smooth and uncultured as she is?
No, I mean the princess has adopted American culture. She behaves just like them.
I agree with you, my sister.
Every time, bullshit, hell, fuck shit, shit shit.
He says that.
We have seen it all night. I now believe.
Anyway, boss, I just came out to say hi. Let me go in there and continue my work.
Okay, Kalinda, okay. Thank you.
I'll see you boss later.
Take care.
Oh, sorry.
Let's continue our game.
Yes.
Okay?
Look, my grandfather is making an arrangement for me that I don't like.
Arrangement?
Yes, arrangement. He wants me to marry a man that I don't love. A man that I've never even laid my eyes on.
My princess, please, I don't want to love from the king, please.
The king won't know, okay? He won't know.
Okay. My princess, I don't want trouble from the king.
There's not going to be
my princess, I'm afraid to take it.
You don't have to be afraid.
My friend, they keep walking me.
The king won't know about Kari, okay? Take. Just make sure you leave the gate open for me tonight. And you'll close it back after I'm gone.
Don't kill me.
Bokari, take. Nothing's gonna happen.
Okay. I will meet my princess.
Good. Now, one more thing. Zip it. No, I didn't mean that. I mean
zip it.
Nobody should know. Good.
Thank you, my princess.
Okay, no problem. Open the gate for me. By 8 p.m.
Okay. Are you going back to Pulo, my princess?
No, I'm not going back. I'm not going back abroad. My grandfather has seized all my traveling documents. And that's the major reason why I want to leave this place today.
Thank you, my princess. Don't kill me.
Here, your highnesses.
Have you seen Princess Janice?
My highness, I came from yesterday, I do not see the places.
Lie! You are the last person that sees who comes in and who goes out. If you don't tell me the truth, I'll make you regret the day you born.
I swear, I do not know, sir. I do not know.
God, arrest this bastard here.
Please, my king, I'm sorry. I beg, I'm sorry. She gave me paper to change into money from the bank so that I will let the gate open wide, please.
How dare you?
You leave the gate open for her to escape?
Baby.
You are a big fool. So all of you, big fools. Now, all of you go out and find her. And never return without her.
Please, that is the gift, please.
Please! What are we going to do now? This is serious.
Hello? Yeah, is that the commissioner? Yes, it's the king. It's an emergency in my palace. Thank you. Okay. I'll call the commissioner. Scan him.
Some water. come on. Cool yourself down, come on. Are you okay, huh?
Who are you?
I'm not a bad guy.
Then tell me who you are and what
you know who I am, Janice.
Who's Janice?
Why are you pretending? Huh? Tell me, huh? Why are you acting as if you don't know me?
I don't know you, okay? And tell me what you want from me.
For God's sake, why did you run away? Huh? Tell me. Why didn't you give me that beautiful chance for me to be with you?
What are you talking about?
We are supposed to get married, but you scampered away.
What? You and me get married?
Oh, you Johnny, stop acting like this! Why are you pretending? Janice?
I'm calling me that, okay? I am not Janice!
No, you are not! You are Janice Abanya, and we both know that. Just like I am Alan Kaikai, the guy you are supposed to get married to. So quit pretending as if I'm some damn stranger you've never laid your eyes on before.
Oh my god. Who have I just landed myself into? What is all this?
Listen, I'm very sorry. I'm sorry if I wrecked your wedding, but it will be a huge mistake for you of all people to get married to some guy who we just met. And that your grandfather is even a pilgrim.
What the hell are you rattling about? Look, I don't have the slightest clue about what you're saying, okay? You might be right about my getting married to Bernard being a mistake, but that's certainly none of your business. And I don't even have a grandfather you keep talking about. Look, mister, you just kidnapped the wrong person.
Of course you know who your grandfather is. Yes, and he is the reason why I'm here.
Look, I am sick and tired of all this, okay? So just take me back home. I won't press charges.
You mean you are not Janice?
That's right, I am not.
Then who are you?
Fine. Like I told you earlier on, I am Alexis Sandy. And I am from Kujiru Kingdom.
You are not Janice Banner. And you do not know your grandfather. And even Queen Mira.
Exactly.
This is unbelievable. Okay, you know what? It's already late now, as you can see. You'll have to spend the night here and tomorrow I'll take you home. How about that?
You just spoiled what was supposed to be the happiest day of my life. Just look at me.
I said I'm sorry. I am truly, truly sorry.
Is this what you do every morning after kidnapping people?
I'll take an exception to that. I wish you wouldn't use that's what I mean.
What would you have me call it? A blind date?
You look nice in that outfit.
Oh yeah, I'm looking nice in your outfit.
What would you like to eat?
Nothing. I'm not ready to eat anything. So tell me, how did you know about me?
But yeah, you first tell me why you decided to run away.
How many times do I have to tell you that it wasn't me? Look, I'm not your Jasmine, okay? And I've never laid my eyes on you before.
Look, Janice, if you think you can fool me by pretending your name is wrong, then you must be mistaken. As soon as you admit who you are, then we can work this out. I mean, we can work this out amicably.
God, this is crazy. Do you want to marry a complete stranger?
Listen, if you had stuck around, we would have gotten to know each other, wouldn't we? Tell me.
If I am who you think I am, I certainly wouldn't have left you. Why would any woman want to leave you, mister?
But you did.
Did I? Are you sure it was me?
Are you sure that you are not a Janice
Banya? Yes, I am not Janice Banya!
Okay. Give me a minute. Can you explain this?
This is a photograph of my fiance and I.
Well, this is what your grandfather used to describe.
And this is what we used to announce our engagement!
I see.
I don't have a grandfather! How many times do I have to tell you that I don't have a grandfather?
Give me a break. You don't have a grandfather.
I don't have a grandfather.
And your parents are both dead.
Yes, you're right.
How convenient. Can you explain this as well?
How many times do I have to tell you that it wasn't me? Oh my God. What? The lady in this picture, is this Janice Banya?
So you can recognize yourself.
This is not me, for God's sake! But the resemblance! Look, it's so uncanny! Is this Janice Banya?
You said the resemblance. Okay. I'll have to leave you for you to sort yourself out. After which, you can let me know. I'm out.
Oh my God. What is this? If this lady in these pictures can look exactly like me, then I think there is more to this than meets the eye. I have to get to the bottom of this matter. What? Just look at her. Exactly like me. And to unravel all these mysteries, I think I have to start pretending that I am this Janice Banya. As from this moment on, I, Alexis Sandy, am Janice Banya.
How are you?
I'm fine. One of the dresses works for me.
Yeah, I can see that. It's nice. You're looking nice in it.
Thank you.
You like it, right?
Yes.
Come sit.
Me?
Yes. Janice?
Yes.
I was thinking, are you not worried about your people in Kudu might be looking for you?
I have nothing to worry about.
Why?
Well, actually, I'd written Bernard a letter. And I guess I must have dropped it when I fainted the day you took me away.
So, what kind of letter will keep people from wondering about you?
One telling him that I'd changed my mind about marrying him. But I never intended, I never wished for him to see it. No way.
So why did you change your mind?
I never wanted to hurt Bernard. But I came to realize that my feelings for him weren't true. So, I had to quit.
So, Janice, tell me, are you thinking of going back?
No, not now.
Why?
I've fallen in love with you.
Excuse me. Janice, sincerely speaking, I've never in my entire life been this positive about you, about my feelings. I must confess, I love you.
So, what next?
Like what?
I thought you said you were going to take me to the king, my grandfather, and my mother.
Yes. I know you were eager to see your grandfather and even Queen Mila.
Yes.
Okay. That would be
so
a problem.
So, where are we going?
Tonight.
Tonight? Let's start. Okay. So, let's go.
My name is Alan Sande. When Alan abducted me from my brother, I told him that he has kidnapped a new person, that I am not Chance. But he didn't believe me. From what he told me, and from the photo of Chance he showed me, I got the impression that both of us might be related.
What? There is a superficial resemblance that I cannot hide. But you are not Chance. You know what you are? You are just an individual opportunist. That's what you are. Tell me, did you decide to go along with this misidentification thing when you learned about the royalty?
Are you really the one of Chance? Could you possibly be my mother?
Oh, shut up! Where on earth did you get that frivolous question of yours?
Apparently, I look enough like your daughter, Janice. Even Al is very much convinced that I am his fiancé. But young woman,
I assure you that I am not your mother, and nor is my daughter related to you in any way. Apparently, your resemblance to her is just one of those inexplicable coincidences.
You call that a coincidence?
Of course, yes!
Well, I think there's more to that.
Young woman, if you were looking for loyalty, you'd come to the wrong place.
None of this was my idea.
Ah, there you are.
Alan, you came in at the right time.
I have already told him.
Told me what?
That this young lady is not Janice.
What?
Well, how could you?
Janice, what kind of game is this?
Alexis, remember?
Then why did
you... I told you, but you didn't believe me.
Then why did you accept that you were Janice?
Because I want to know if I'm related to her.
You see? Liar! You are nothing but a liar. You are fortune hunter. That's what you are.
No. No, Your Majesty. With due respect, Your Majesty, stop calling her that. Yes. She's no fortune hunter. She was telling me the truth. Yes. But I couldn't believe her.
You see. Alan. I urge you to take this thing to wherever you brought her from.
I need to sleep with the king.
There is no need to sleep with the king. She must leave immediately.
Your Majesty, she will not leave until the king sees her.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yes.
Then we shall stick to that.
There is no need for just identity. But I promise you, I must get to the bottom of this.
That's what I told you too. And that is why I promise you to this place.
Yes. But I want you to promise me one thing. That you will never, I will never leave you.
I promise I will leave you.
Janice! What is wrong with you? You came here late last night and here you are disturbing me and the neighbors. Don't you have something else better to do? You are a princess for goodness sake. A representative of your grandfather's palace. By the way, where are you off to this morning? Stop staring at me, I'm not a change person.
Change person indeed. I get it.
Tara, you're so tired of me staying here with you, right? You want me out. No, I didn't say that. But you don't have to say anything, girlfriend, for me to understand. Because these days it is either Charlie's, the house is in a mess, Charlie's, the music is so loud, or Charlie's, you love the TV on. I can't. You know that's not the point. For 3 months now, you've been living your life on a fast lane. What is wrong with you?
And what business of yours is that?
Now, read my top. It says royalty. Blue blood flows in my veins, girlfriend, and you know that. I'm a princess. An heiress to the whole throne. My grandfather's throne. Don't you hear my inability for this dumpster you call a house? This dumpster has been your shelter for the past 3 months, remember?
What am I even doing here anyways? Me doing. But I didn't ask you to leave. You don't have to. That's my goddamn business. It's my life. I'm doing my way. If you don't like my way, you hit the hard way. I'm out of here. Janice! Janice! Well, I guess you're leaving for your grandfather's palace.
Janice? No! This is not Janice. My God. She looks like Janice.
Your Majesty. Do you mean this is not Janice?
She's not. I can recognize Janice if I see her.
She told me, but I didn't believe her until now.
My daughter, who are you?
My name is Alex Sande, and I grew up in Uyo Kenya.
And who are your parents?
My parents are both dead. I'm adopted.
My instinct is telling me there's more to this. And I intend going into the depths of this mystery surrounding your background. Alan!
Your Majesty.
Summon everyone in the palace tomorrow morning.
It shall be done, Your Majesty.
Okay.
Let's go.
They're
outside on a duty.
Okay. Well, I summon you all here for a meeting. There is a situation. You all see the lady coming. You all know Princess Janet.
Yes, ma'am.
So you will say she's Princess Janice. Well, no. I say unto you, she's not Princess Janice. So, I want somebody to tell you something. What is going on in this palace? I want to know. I need an explanation. Because she's not Princess Janice. Maya! Yes, sit down. Look. You will say she's Princess Janice, but no, she's not. I need an explanation.
I don't understand.
Hey. Look at her carefully. You brought Princess Janice to this house. From America.
saying that she is your daughter. But, so, explain to me.
My king.
Yes?
This is just a mere coincidence. For God's sake, thousands of babies are...
Thousands of babies aren't clones of each other? So, tell me the truth. I want to know the truth.
My king! I know what happened.
Really? Come forward. Tell us everything you know! Everything you know! Sit down.
My king, your son, our prince, had a secret lover. Her name was Rose.
What? A secret lover?
She was a dancer. As a maid in the palace, I used to help her sneak out of the house whenever she comes over to sleep with the prince. Later told me that Rose was pregnant.
My prince, I'm glad you came.
Rose.
My prince, I'm going to have your baby.
What? Are you serious?
Yes, my prince.
I'm gonna be your father.
My prince.
What?
But I'm scared.
Why are you scared?
Your wife. Your father. Your throne.
Look. Look, my dear. You have nothing to worry about. You are going to keep this baby and I will find the right time to explain this to them. Okay? Okay?
Okay, my prince.
And the queen was going to adopt the children.
Why?
My husband.
I have something to tell you.
What is it?
But promise me first that you will forgive me.
I promise you, I will forgive you.
I have children with a girl called Rose. She stays at Shalmingo. Please bring them to this palace and let my father take care of them.
Alright, master. I will do just that.
Thank you.
Later, the queen went to America. Before she came back, the prince had died. That's what really happened, my king.
Hey, Maya!
King.
All this time, you know about this. And all the time you're telling me lies?
No.
it was not for the sake of my son, I would have driven you out of this palace. You are wicked. And God will judge you. Yes. My dear, you are most welcome to this palace. This is your rightful place and your family. You're most welcome. And I want you to feel free. Please.
So, I had a sister all along. It's my sister.
Yes, that is absolutely true. But never mind, my dear. Everything will be alright. Everything will be alright.
Your Majesty.
Yes, my dear.
Kindly permit me to go back to Kujiru Kingdom and inform my foster family about this new development.
Okay. You have a point. No problem with it. As long as you promise me that you'll be coming back, because this is where you rightfully belong.
I will, Your Majesty.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Your Majesty.
Yes.
What is going on here?
Good afternoon.
Hold it right here. I don't extend pleasantries with commoners. A commoner? That's what you are in your whiskey.
Playing with your mates? I can see you must be very, very idle. Now go to the kitchen and have some travel that will keep you busy. Now,
I beg your pardon, Your Majesty.
To beg what?
What are the mates here for? If you want me to do the chores for you, then why are the maids being paid?
How dare you question my authority, you good for nothing girl?
Ah! Hey, what's going on?
Your Highness!
Grandfather, you have to tell me.
Question.
Your Highness.
Yes.
I knew from the start that this girl is up to no good.
Mm-hmm.
Can you imagine what she was doing? She was actually playing with the maids. Something Princess Shani's will never do.
What? What is wrong with that? I mean, if she has chosen to be friendly with her mates, then so be it. I don't see anything wrong with it. You see, humility, which is a virtue that every royal sure. Alex.
Your Highness.
Yes.
I must depend
on you. Okay. Don't allow her to spoil your day. Go back to what you're doing.
Please, Grandfather.
Okay, man.
Thank you, Grandfather. Any life left in her to run back to wherever she's coming from. Fight by her.
right now. Where are you? I hope you haven't get out of town. Good. I have a mission. Meet me at one of same time.
Yes, sister.
I have no time to waste. Inside this envelope, you will find a photograph of the virus that I want you to delete. And also, there is a sum of 2 million, which is your deposit, and you will get the balance when the job is perfectly done. Take.
I will take. Look, I'm ready to do the job. But you know how serious and dangerous the job is. Therefore, you have to make it immediately.
Say what? I don't have that kind of money, Viper. What is wrong with you and money?
You don't have no right to question my decision. This is my office, okay?
Okay, fine, fine. You can have this for now. And when the job is perfectly completed, then your demands will be granted. Deal?
Yeah.
Fine, take.
Consider the job done.
One more thing. You will find her at our usual supermarket. And make no mistake about it.
Trust me.
Good.
Fine.
Abroad for surgery. That's exactly what I was thinking. I'll do everything I can.
Hey, Jack.
It's just that I miss Princess Alexis. We all do. But that's not all. Something that has been baffling me about this whole issue is that one of the thugs actually called her Princess Janice. Even though she is elder, who wants to hurt her?
Hurt who?
I mean Princess Janice.
Are you asking me? Anyway, I'm glad you said it yourself that she's so arrogant. She could have made a lot of enemies, you know. It's rather unfortunate that Princess Alexis had to leave the world.
It's been 1 week since she's gone. I pray that the project will be successful.
It will. Stop worrying yourself. I'm not leaving this place, okay?
Okay, thank you.
Leave me alone! Get your filthy hands off
me! Leave me alone! Yeah.
Get your filthy hands off
me! Leave me alone! Get your filthy hands off me!
My God!
No! You stink! Officer! Good day, Your Majesty.
Yes.
I met Prince Janice assaulting this young lady.
Oh my God!
Think of the fact that she absconded from the palace a few months back, so I had to bring her here.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Young lady, what happened?
Your Majesty, I caught Princess Dennis here with my boyfriend some days ago. This morning on my way to town, I met her on the way and decided to advise her to leave my boyfriend for me. Mm-hmm. She got offended and she broke my head with the bottle of wine she was drinking from.
Guys, seriously and truly, you are a disgrace to this world. Oh,
she hasn't seen anything yet.
Shut up! My dear, I am very, very sorry. Okay? Dad, take her to the palace gate.
Thank you, my dear.
Okay, my dear.
Oh my goodness, you are jealous.
Who the hell do you think I am?
Behave yourself until you meet your sister.
I have a sister.
Get out! Get out! Get out!
Your final day and your face will be beautiful. May be first and found. Beautiful. You like it? Today we will be starting, okay? She about to go back to Africa, huh? Remember to take your drugs. and stay away from flammable things, okay? Especially fire. I will talk to the nurse for them to take you out, okay?
Heard. Guess what? Oh my god, here I am, thinking that I was an only child. But hey, Grandfather just told me. He just told me that I have a sister, Mother. Not just an ordinary sister, Mother, but another half of me, my twin sister. Grandfather says she traveled. She went to put the surgery. Mother, is it true? Mother, is it true?
What? And how come? How come you never told me all this?
See, let me tell you a little story. When I gave birth to you, you were twins. But I never saw my other daughter. Because tradition demands that one of you should be raised outside the palace. But as you grow up, your other sister became so jealous of you. Because you were the one that was raised in royalty and to be the next queen.
I don't understand. Like, how come she's back here? How did she get back to this palace?
She only showed up when she realized that she ran away from the palace.
Because you refused to marry Alan. And now, they are both married.
Wow. Oh my god. I can't wait to see my sister.
Oh, you shut up!
Janice?
But Mother, I'm happy for her. She's my sister.
I am your mother, Janice. Can't you see? She's here to win you!
For God's sake, Julius. Alexis is going to take everything that belongs to you. He's going to take your place. Can't you see? Open your eyes and see!
How is that going to be possible?
How did I have told you that you have a sister that fits you? Even without knowing you, Alexis gave you the passion of Janice. She has actually taken everything, I mean everything that belongs to you. Alan, your grandfather's love, and even your mates. For God's sake, how can a mother like me love a daughter like Alexis?
Never. That can never be possible.
It's time for you to take what rightfully belongs to you.
But I must say, running away from this palace was the greatest mistake you ever made. Because you ruined everything, Janice.
I'm sorry. Mother, I'm sorry. I'm so, so sorry, okay?
You know, I never meant to hurt you. I never knew that things would turn out this way. I'm so sorry.
Understand. But don't worry. Allah was supposed to be your step, and that he will always be. So, go up and clean it off.
Mother, you see your girl? Your girl is back. And she's back for real. As for that idiot that calls us a Phalanxes, she'll meet me. When she comes back from her surgery, she will meet me. I'm going to deal with her so badly that she'll regret ever stepping her feet into this palace. I'm the only princess of this kingdom, and that I will ever be. Do you need another princess in this kingdom?
Not at all.
Do grandfather want another princess in this kingdom?
No.
Then I am the only princess of Bonito Kingdom. I will remain. Alexis, she doesn't know what is waiting for her. Let her come.
That's my daughter.
Mother?
Now you are talking like the real daughter of me.
I'm going to tell you. Don't worry. I trust you. Thank you. Thanks for being with me. Okay, mother. Take care. Bye-bye. Princess, indeed. She'll meet me here. Idiots.